Welcome to this video. Today we are going to talk about, should you rent gear for your photography or videography, filmmaking? Should you rent gear? Is that a good idea? My name is Wes. Welcome to Wes Preetzel Photo. If this is your first time to the channel, I do Canon videos and Fuji videos, and I'm glad you're here. As a matter of fact, you're a beautiful person and a good person. If no one has told you that today, let me be the first one to tell you that. I think there are three reasons why, and probably more, that you should rent video and photography gear. Today I'm filming on the Fuji. It's the 18 to 55 millimeter lens. It goes from a 2.8 to f4. And why did I want to rent this lens and try it out? Patrick Tommaso on Twitter said, there's none better than the kit lens for filming and video, for particularly for autofocus. And so the kit lens on the XE4 is the 27 millimeter pancake lens. I asked him, is that the one? He's like, no, it's the 18 to 55 millimeter. So I rented it to check it out to see how it does with autofocus. So right now this video is a test, and I'm watching, actually I'm going to video how it does with the tracking, filming on my phone. So you could see how it films, how it tracks with me, pretty good. It seems pretty darn good. Go out of the frame, back into the frame. It's good. All right, so there's three reasons why you might want to rent gear. Actually, four now that I think about it, but let's hold off on that last one. So concept number one is purpose. You rent gear to see if it fits your purpose. When you're renting that gear, you're gonna be testing it out and looking for specific qualities of the gear. How does it perform? You might know specs about it, but there's some things in real life that don't translate, like intangible things like ergonomics or just some funny little idiosyncrasies of that gear that are hard to pick up off the web page when you're reading about it. So when you rent it, you're having the purpose, that focus of, does it fit you? So is this piece of gear, yes, it's good for a lot of people, many people, is it a good fit for you? And is it, does it have that special purpose of being part of your kit or your gear? So that's one. Number two is precision. When you rent gear, typically you go into using it with that mindset of, I'm using it for this specific reason. Now, there may be people who are flush with cash and they can just rent all the gear they want and see if any of it hits and sticks. But for me, when I rent, I know this lens, I'm trying it out to see if it actually fits my purpose of talking head video. Does it lock on the autofocus? Really, that's all I care about is autofocus. Now, I took it, of course, when I rented it and took a bunch of photos. Actually, I have to return it tonight in about an hour, but all I had done to this point is use it for photography. I fell in love with this lens for its photos. It's amazing, great capabilities in terms of photos. But my precision, my precise reason for renting it was to find out, does it track well for autofocus? So there's a little bit of a test. This is me in my new YouTube space. I haven't kind of got the sound dialed in. Obviously, it's probably echoey. I haven't got the lighting dialed in, but I'm just testing that autofocus tracking piece. I've had the 10 to 24. I've had the 23 millimeter f2 in the past, and I find they jump ship a little bit. So I wanted to find a good lens that I would feel comfortable. And that is the precise reason for renting this piece of gear for me. So we have purpose. Does it fit your purpose? Purpose as a filmmaker or photographer. Precision, when you rent, you look at it through a different lens, so to speak. And the last thing is price. Now, if you think about the purpose and the precision, the price for this piece of gear comes into focus, another photography pun, and you realize this price is actually worth paying, or it's not worth paying for a piece of gear. Now, you can always buy it and live with it and sell it if you don't want. But again, that includes hassle, that includes some expense, and it probably depreciates and you lose some of the value that you invested. So far, I'm liking this lens, but I really won't make a judgment until I edit this video and see, is it good? So just remember, yes, I highly recommend that you should rent gear, find if it fits your purpose, look at it with a precise view of what you want out of it, and then determine if it's a good price. One other thing, filming in the new studio space, I'm just gonna light my personal fireplace, which is a little feature that I like to include in my videos. It's kind of something warm and cozy. And I asked people what I should include in the new studio space, and this was one of the things that they said they liked. All right, so you have to remember, fourth, there's another reason why to rent gear. And that's, let's say you're doing a shoot, somebody hires you, contracts you out, they want to use your services, And part of the work requires something that you don't currently have, or some piece of gear that would allow you to hit the level of excellence to deliver the goods for the client. And so another reason, fourth reason, is to rent something for a project. So we have purpose, we have precision, we have that price. And then if it's just a one-off, it's not really something you're looking at buying, you just rent it for a project. That enables you to successfully complete a gig for a client. Now, recently I was out on a film set or a commercial shoot. A friend of mine, Will Utley, shout out to Will, asked me if I had a Canon R5. I said, no, but I can get one. And so I rented it that night from a guy on ShareGrid, and I went to the set the next day and filmed with it the whole day. So then there's actually a fifth reason that makes me think of. There's actually a fifth reason that makes me think of, and that's pro. Now, because I've rented the R5 before, Will asked me, could I get one for a project the next day? So because I'd rented it, I could walk in like a pro, knowing my way around the camera, a camera I didn't own, but I had access to by renting it. And so it allowed me to be a professional and to step into a job and bring that gear with me. Now, some of the higher value cameras, the Komodos, the cinema cameras, you actually bring that with you as an asset when you're working on a project, and you're actually able to then rent it out and make money when you're not shooting. So those are some other things to consider, but I just like to think of these five things. Yes, five. Rent with a purpose to see if it fits you. Rent with precision to see if it's exactly what you need, and consider the price if you're gonna purchase it. You might pick it up as a rental for a project, and it allows you to step into that space as a pro. Now, if you like this video, stick around, click subscribe, click like, because I'm gonna make more videos like this. And I'm really excited about the YouTube studio space that's shaping up. And thank you, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you for joining me. Like always, I'd like to connect with you in the comments. Let me know some other reasons I missed, or some reasons not to rent and maybe just to go straight to buy. Again, I'm not the authority. I'm not the person who knows it all. It's just a person who likes to learn and teach and share with other people on this journey. All right, see you in the next video. Oh, subscribe if you haven't subscribed. Like this video, and please leave me a comment. It means so much to me. Next time.